Hello, everybody. Welcome back and welcome to Mad Ferret Studios, Booty in the House. Part 5 of Bramble the Mountain King. We defeated Pesta, also known as Pestilence, and have now arrived at the mountain where Bramble is. Let us continue Olle's chapter. That can't be good. Wow.
As he reached the summit, Olle felt regret.
Oh, so it's a maze. Okay. Oh, well, I guess I can't do that, huh?
As he reached the summit, Olle felt regret.
Okay, there we go.
sister from being taken. The grim could not stop the woman from drowning her child. Shapeshifter in the forest.
Well, son, you really didn't have much of a choice.
Now the mountain stood before him, and he wished he could ask their forgiveness.
Whoa.
He had reached the end that Tuva had pointed him towards. Now, entering the halls of the mountain, Olle was ready to find his sister. Long ago, there was a peaceful kingdom that lacked an heir to the throne. King Nils and his queen Magdalena had waited for a long time, and at last she was expecting a child. She gave birth to the longed-for son, and they named him Ulrich. Magdalena succumbed to the labors of childbirth. The love of his life was gone. Weighed down by sorrow, King Nils approached his autumn. Meanwhile, Ulrich grew into a young boy full of life. The prince was the only thing that kept the darkness at bay in his heart. One day, Prince Ulrich fell ill. The doctors tried everything, but he grew weaker and weaker. They told King Nils about a mythical flower that witches were rumored to use to heal any illness. King Nils searched the whole kingdom for the flower to no avail, and his campaign soon became a gruesome witch hunt. His path was lined with the witches he had slain, but the flower was nowhere to be found. King Nil. His path was lined with the witches.
Part two? Okay, yep.
Exhausted, bloody, and at his wits' end, King Nils came to a witch's house on the outskirts of his kingdom. He fell to his knees, begging the witch to help cure his son, and she agreed. The witch explained that the flower held tremendous power that could only very carefully be used for good. The witch instructed he only use a single petal. Using the whole bloom would only invite death. Ulrich began to recover, but discontent at the royal line had grown in the kingdom following King Nils' bloody campaign. The next day, King Nils found his son dead. And the last light holding his darkness at bay was snuffed out. Heartbroken, King Nils turned to the bloom which had promised life, and instead saw it as an escape from his suffering. The witch, having come to visit the king and the prince, looked at the nightmarish scene in despair. She raised a mountain on top of King Nils and shackled him using the same bramble that he let loose upon the kingdom. And to this day, the trolls still feed him as punishment for his evil deed.
Oh. Look to the Goobin. Oh, okay. Beautiful artwork. That's not triggering.
Oh.
Okay. Oh, wait, okay. Those are clock hands. Two. Wait a minute. Okay, so that's six. Okay, what am I missing here? Okay, I got it. There we go. Okay, 5, 2, and 10. I was missing the 10 part. Where the hell did I miss the 10 part? Okay. I got the 2 and I got the 6. It was 6, 2, and 10. I completely missed the 10 part. I see, okay. Thank you.
forever, now opened.
Wow.
Mountain King, who was meant to be hidden forever, was now revealed. He just had to reach the sack before Lillimor ended up as the giant's dinner.
Can I not climb? What the fuck? How the fuck am I supposed to get up there? All right, this is ridiculous. Okay, I figured it out. I have to climb the goddamn sword. Jesus. Oh, that wasn't supposed to happen, was it? Fuck. Jesus Christ. Damn it.
Thank you.
finally. Jesus Christ. Finally! God
the
damn!
The Brahmin weakened. The Mountain King saw clearly for the first time.
How long did that
centuries.
Fucking take me to do it?
And what he saw reminded him of his beloved son. He would not lose him again. This time, King Nils would overcome the darkness. King Nils tore the bramble rooted in his back and brought it all to an end. The only way to get to Lilimur was now up and in.
Run faster! Oh lord. This better not be fucking timed. I'm gonna be pissed. I'm over this timed shit.
Tuva had one last gift to give to Olle.
To move a lot faster than that, sister.
Lemus would always look after his friend.
Good Lemus. Man, some of those fight scenes are a bitch. Especially when you have to time it just right and...
The nightmare woke her up.
Olle is, like, so slow.
Frightened by her memories. She searched for her brother's comfort. But he was nowhere to be found.
There's all the pieces.
However, the darkness outside did not scare her. Because she knew she had her brother.
Aww. Headless chicken games. Okay, I have to say it. Yeah, for all my frustrations with some parts of this, with especially like the boss battling scenes were just frustrating me on no end, just because of the to me the slowness and the absolute slowness timing you had to do. This was a fantastic game. I loved it. Very in-depth, very story-driven. So if you have not played this game, grab it and play it. Again, if you are sensitive to certain objects or certain subjects, you know, like what the disclaimer was saying in the front of the video, you may want to avoid this, obviously. But I enjoyed it. I love games like this. I wish there were more of them. So, like, I did the Cursed Forest for Halloween. I enjoyed the fuck out of that game. That was absolutely fantastic. So, that is the end of Bramble the Mountain King. Go grab it if you haven't got it. It's a lot of fun. Very deep storytelling. And I will see you guys on the next game, which I have no idea what my next single-player game is. Could be one of my cozy games. I might go back into Skyrim. Or whatnot. I have no idea. You'll find out. And with that, I will see you guys on the next episode of whatever. Bye.